students, in today's video, I will be explaining about the religion of Kushanas and about the Gandhara art. Before going into the video, if anyone is seeing the channel for the first time, please do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. It will be a great encouragement for me. Please do click the bell button to receive notifications. Now let us get into the video. Religion of Kushanas. Kushanas belonged to the Yuchi tribe and followed the tribal religious customs. So in the last video we have seen that the Kushanas were originally a nomadic race known as Yuchi, and they lived in China. So because of this, the Kushanas followed their tribal religious customs. After settling in India, they adopted the Indian culture and Hinduism. Now, after coming to India, they adopted the Indian culture, and naturally Hinduism was the main religion, so they adopted Hinduism. They worshipped the sun god along with other deities. So their main god was sun god, and they worshipped other deities also. Kujala catfishes and Vema catfishes were the followers of Hinduism. So Kujala catfishes, that is catfishes 1, and Vima catfishes were followers of Hinduism. Kanishka was also a follower of Hinduism, and the coins of Kanishka bear the images of Persian, Greek and Hindu gods. So Kujala catfishes, Vima catfishes and Kanishka all were followers of Hinduism. The coins of Kanishka bear the images of Persian, Greek and Hindu gods. He later embraced Buddhism under the influence of Ashwaghosha. Now Kanishka was a person who later on embraced Buddhism. This was under the influence of Ashwaghosha. So Kushanas, they belong to Yuchi tribe of China, and they followed their tribal religious customs. After settling in India, they adopted the Indian culture and Hinduism. They worshipped sun god along with other deities. Kujala catfishes, Vima catfishes and Kanishka were followers of Hinduism. The coins of Kanishka bear the images of Persian, Greek and Hindu gods. Kanishka later embraced Buddhism under the influence of Ashwaghosha, and he took many measures for the spread of Buddhism. Kanishka was a person who took many measures for the spread of Buddhism. It was due to the efforts of Kanishka that Buddhism spread into China, Tibet, Japan and Central Asian countries. So because of the effort of Kanishka, Buddhism spread to countries like China, Tibet, Japan and Central Asian countries. Now what were the measures taken by Kanishka for the spread of Buddhism? We saw that Kanishka was first a follower of Hinduism, and later he embraced Buddhism because of the influence of Ashwaghosha, and he took many measures to spread Buddhism, and because of his efforts only Buddhism had spread to many countries. Now what were those measures which Kanishka took for the spread of Buddhism? The first measure was Buddhism was given royal patronage, and it was extended to the Buddhist monks. That is, Kanishka was a king. He gave royal patronage, or encouragement from the king was given to Buddhism, and this encouragement was extended to the Buddhist monks also. So when a religion get the support of the king or the royal family, that naturally spread very easily. So Buddhism was given royal patronage, and the royal patronage was extended to the Buddhist monks also. Viharas and monasteries were built for the use of the monks. Viharas and monasteries, a place where Buddhist monks live, those were built in large number in his empire, and these were given for the monks to use, viharas and monasteries. Many missionaries were sent to foreign countries like Japan, Tibet and parts of Central Asia for the spread of Buddhism. Now Kanishka sent many missionaries to foreign countries like Japan, Tibet and parts of Central Asia for the spread of Buddhism. So because of all these efforts also, Buddhism spread to many countries. If we see, we can compare Kanishka's measures like the same of Ashoka. Ashoka also had done many measures to spread of Buddhism. Likewise, Kanishka also had done many things for the spread of Buddhism. That is, he gave royal patronage, viharas and monasteries were built for the use of monks, many missionaries were sent to foreign countries for the spread of Buddhism. Kanishka conducted the fourth Buddhist council at Kundalavana in Kashmir in 102 century era. This was one of the most important measure taken by Kanishka. He conducted the fourth Buddhist council at Kundalavana in Kashmir in 102 century era. This council was presided over by Vasumitra. So the fourth Buddhist council conducted at Kundalavana in Kashmir in 102 century era, and it was presided by Vasumitra. The main purpose of this council was to settle the disputes existing in Buddhism at that time. So during this time, some disputes or some difference of opinion have started among the Buddhist monks. To settle these disputes or to solve this difference of opinion, the fourth Buddhist council was organized. So it was organized to settle the disputes existing in Buddhism at that time. In this council, a commentary on the holy books, that is Pitikas, was prepared. So in the fourth Buddhist council, a commentary or a discussion about the holy books, that is Pitikas, was prepared. This was later brought together in the form of a book called as Mahavibhasha. So when we studied about Buddhism, we have studied about the three Pitakas, that is Vinaya Pitaka, Sutta Pitaka and Abhidhamma Pitaka. So in this fourth Buddhist council, a commentary on the holy books was prepared, and this was later brought together in the form of a book called as Mahavibhasha. So the commentary on the holy books of Buddhism is called as Mahavibhasha. This is one of the authoritative books on Buddhist philosophy. So this Mahavibhasha is one of the most authoritative books on Buddhist philosophy. So the main fourth Buddhist council was held at Kundalavana in Kashmir in 102 century era. It was presided by Vasumitra. The main purpose of this was to settle disputes existing in Buddhism at that time. And in this council, a commentary on the holy books, that is Pitikas, was prepared, and this was later brought together in the form of a book called as Mahavibhasha. This is one of the most authoritative books on the Buddhist philosophy. So all these were the measures taken by Kanishka for the spread of Buddhism. Now let us see about the Gandhara art. Kanishka was a great patron of art. So King Kanishka was a great patron. He encouraged art. Many important constructions of art are found at Gandhara, Mathura, Kanishkapura, Takshashila. In all these places, many important constructions of art have been found. So Kanishka was a great patron of art, and many important constructions of art are found at places like Gandhara, Mathura, Kanishkapura and Takshashila. The period of Kushanas is important or is known for the growth of Gandhara art. So when we hear about the period of Kushanas, the main thing which comes to our mind is Gandhara school of art. Gandhara art is otherwise known as the Greco-Buddhist style of art. Now what is the speciality of Gandhara art? Gandhara art is also called as the Greco-Buddhist style of art. This was because of the close contact between the two civilizations, that is the Indian and Greek civilization had close contact. Because of this, the art came to be called as Greco-Buddhist style of art. Because of this, this kind of an art developed. The Gandhara school of art represented a blending of Indian and Greek art. So it was a mixture of Indian and Greek art. It is called the Gandhara art because it originated in Gandhara region, which is in present Afghanistan. So this is called as Gandhara art because it originated in Gandhara region, which is in present Afghanistan. So Gandhara art is otherwise known as a Greco-Buddhist style of art because of the close contact between Indian and Greek civilization, there was a blending of Indian and Greek art. It is called as Gandhara art because it originated in Gandhara region. Now let us see what are the chief characteristics of the Gandhara School of Art. What is the speciality of Gandhara School of Art? First is, life-size statues of Gautama Buddha was carved in this school. In Gandhara School of Art, life-size statues, that is statues equal to life size, was carved in this school. Until then, Buddhist existence was shown in the form of symbols like lotus, umbrella, etc. So, till the coming of Gandhara School of Art, Buddhist existence was shown just in the form of symbols like lotus, umbrella, etc. But when Gandhara School of Art came, life-size statues of Gautama Buddha were carved. Second was, utmost care was given to the symmetry of the body while carving the statue. So while the statues were carved, minutest care was given to the symmetry of body, that is muscles and mustaches were shown in natural settings. So all the symmetry of the body, muscles, mustaches, everything was carved with utmost care. Next characteristics was, the folds and turns of the clothes were exhibited with minute care and skill. Even the small details, that is if the clothes of the statue was folded or if there was a turn on the clothes of the statue, all these things, that is folds, turns of the clothes, all were exhibited with minute care and skill. The fourth one, the ornaments that were carved on the statues received much attention. This added to the physical beauty of the statue. The ornaments which the statue had, those ornaments also were carved with much attention. And this added to the physical beauty of the statue. Fifth characteristics was, polishing the statues is an important feature of this art. In Gandhara School of Art, all the statues are well polished. So, polishing the statue was an important feature of this art. The main material used for preparing the statues were stone, terracotta and clay. The statues were mainly made with stone, terracotta and clay. The technique used in making the statues was Greek, but the idea, inspiration and personality were Indian. So in the beginning only we have told that it is a blending of Indian and Greek style. So the technique used in making the statues was Greek, but the idea, inspiration and personality were Indian. According to Dr. R.C. Majumdar, the Gandhara artist had the hand of a Greek but the heart of an Indian. So Dr. R.C. Majumdar have told in a very beautiful way about Gandhara School of Art. He said that the Gandhara artist had the hands of a Greek but the heart of an Indian. So if you see the main characteristics of Gandhara School of Art, life-size statues of Gautama Buddha was carved in this Gandhara school. While carving the statue, utmost care was given to the symmetry of body, including muscles and mustaches, which were shown in natural settings. This in Gandhara School of Art, the folds and turns of the clothes were exhibited with minute care and skill. The ornaments which were carved received much attention and that added to the physical beauty. The statues were well polished. The main material used for preparing the statues were stone, terracotta and clay. The technique used in making the statues was Greek, but the idea, inspiration and personality were Indian. According to Dr. R.C. Majumdar, the Gandhara artist had the hands of a Greek, but the heart of an Indian. So we have seen about the religion of Kushanas, the measures taken by Kanishka for the spread of Buddhism, and we have also seen about the characteristics of Gandhara School of Art. So now let us see some important question and answers in this chapter. Which was the original home of Kushanas? Answer: China. Who was the first ruler of the Kushanas? Kujala Kadphises or Kadphises I. Who was the greatest king of Kushanas? Kanishka. Name the Chinese general who defeated Kanishka. Answer: Pan Chou. Which was the capital of Kanishka? Purushapura. Who influenced Kanishka to embrace Buddhism? Ashwaghosha. Why was the fourth Buddhist council held and when? It was held in 102 century era to settle the disputes existing in Buddhism at that time. So, fourth Buddhist council was held in 102 century era to settle the disputes existing in Buddhism at that time. Write any two measures of Kanishka for the spread of Buddhism. He gave royal patronage to Buddhism. He built viharas and monasteries for the use of the monks. He sent a number of missionaries to foreign countries for the spread of Buddhism. Any two of these measures you can write as an answer. Explain the achievements of Kanishka. Now this is a 5-mark question. The answer is explained in the video under the topic Political History and Conquest of Kanishka. All the points under Political History and Conquest of Kanishka has to be included in this answer. Describe the chief characteristics of the Gandhara school of art. The same answer I have explained in today's video under the topic Characteristics of Gandhara school of art. All the points, all the main characteristics you have to write as an answer for. Describe the chief characteristics of Gandhara school of art. So I hope you have understood the points very clearly. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.